Okay, here we have a different line. It's not even that I say, okay, this is now a distance, because here we have a line as well to practice maybe sometimes to say, okay, keep the rhythm. Here we will have around about 7 strides, depends on the horse as well. This is not direct and related distance. It always depends from which side you come, if you're coming from the turn, which direction you go. So there is as well, it's okay to learn to take a correct rhythm. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3 and a half. Now you see this is actually a very nice, simple, actually steady distance to make this this oxer. It will be a different story when you come from the turn to jump the oxer first. Then it's important, you know, in what direction you go. When you know, you say, okay, I want to be in the time, I have to be shorter, you can cut the inside. When you say, okay, it's very important to go clear, you can stay a little bit more outside. It always depends what kind of size the fences have. When the fences are bigger, we need more room. Then with a bigger distance, a bigger jump, we have a better approach, we have more impulsion, the horse will jump and make a bigger jump. So there, even there, the gallop is more. So that's very important. First is practice small and then try to build this up that you know exactly how the horse is feeling, how he's landing to keep the correct balance. Laura, for your horse?
It's actually exactly what you just said. For the bending lines, I find it really important that you know your horse quite well, because it depends a lot on the stride, depends a lot on where from where you're coming. And also, like one horse of mine, with a big stride, she jumps a lot to the left. So if I jump now the vertical and then the oxer would help me a little bit to stay outside. So yeah, you always have to take this into consideration as well.
We see this distance now the first time when we watched Laura with a quiet rhythm, the green vertical to the yellow oxer. I said, okay, the 7 will be probably a little bit short. She already did the 8. So there you can see that the control is there. Everything is ready. Afterwards, we see a few times the 7 and the 7. Very simple, very easy. But I like to show as well the last time how easy can make the 6. When you have the rhythm, the correct distance, you didn't see it too much in a stride, but one stride less is then no problem. So when you practice short or correct, then it's no problem to develop the stride. But if the horse is running and not in the rhythm, then you always will have the problem to control it again. It's nice that we have here two different horses with different strides. The one with the smaller stride and the big, and the other one with the bigger stride. And that we can see that we can play with the distance. I think this is very important, that to learn how your horse is taking the rhythm and the gallop. Now we will see Laura to do the first distance even with 9 strides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It looks still very good and very smooth. And we can see then later, you know, that it's okay how easy it is to make one stride less. And then we're gonna count now the same thing from the oxer to the vertical. We do now the 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is to start with the horse is very simple and very correct. And then we're going to see the next time that's okay, even when we make the fences a little bit bigger, we're going to see very simple how she is doing now the 7 strides. We will count once more just to see it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You see the rhythm is the same, the balance is the same, and it's very simple, very correct, and I'm happy with that.
We see the development of the horse from the last videos, and this is actually for me the nice thing to see the future.